Okay, so we're going to learn how to make a fill-in-the-blank PixWriter activity. So the first thing you need to do is we're going to create the symbol that will stand in for our blank. So to do that, we're going to use target words. So you can go to the target or hit Control-T. Decide what your symbol is going to be. Mine's going to be 3 question marks. And then I need a picture for it. So I'm going to go alternate picture, and I'm going to put in question because I want that question mark. And then I want it to say not question mark, question mark, question mark. I want it to say blank. Click on add target. Okay. Now you'll notice here's that question mark in my word bank that I can click on to use. The other thing I'm going to do is, since we're only going to make a 3 question activity, I'm going to change my word bank size to 16 buttons just so my buttons are a little bigger. And then I'm going to go ahead and type in my words for the answer. So we're going to do a weather quiz, so we'll do rain, snow, and fog. Okay, I'm going to drag them around so I have them organized. So I'm going to use shift. I'm going to hold down shift and then drag that button where I want it. Now the next thing I'm going to do, and this is important, is I'm going to click lock the toolbar, which is this icon right here. Now I can't add anything else to my toolbar, so if I start typing things, they won't go in, which is what we want. So the other thing I need to do is clear out this paper up here, so I'm going to hit the escape key to quickly clear it. So I'm going to start typing in my question, my fill in the blank, so water falling from the sky is called, and then this is where my students would fill in rain, so I'm going to put in that question mark. All right, you would continue doing that for your other questions, for your other blanks. Okay, so I've gone ahead in and filled in the rest of my fill in the blanks. So I have water from the sky for rain, cloud on the ground for fog, and then frozen water for snow. So the next thing I need to do is get rid of this question mark in my word bank. Now remember, we locked our word bank. So what we're going to need to do is go to edit and unlock the word bank, or you can just hit Control L. I'm going to hold down Control and click on the picture of my question symbol, and now it's gone. So I'm going to go ahead and lock my word bank one more time, and then when my students are ready to answer, they can say water falling from the sky is called Okay, click on that set of question marks. Water falling from the sky is rain. And then it inserted rain. And that is how you make a fill-in-the-blank activity in PixWriter. Super simple.